Vietnam's top cop Tho Lam is elected as state president by the National Assembly. While the role is largely ceremonial, analysts see his appointment as a potential stepping stone for the position of chief of the ruling Communist Party. As head of the Public Security Ministry, Lam has been at the center of a sweeping anti-graft campaign aimed at rooting out widespread corruption in government. The state presidency is one of Vietnam's top four political positions. The others are the party chief, the prime minister, and the parliament speaker. Tech enthusiasts descend on South Korea today, Wednesday, for a global forum on artificial intelligence. Companies joining this year's summit include U.S. tech giants OpenAI, Google, and Microsoft, all at the forefront of developing AI. South Korean Prime Minister Han Duck-soo stressed the importance of ensuring safety in AI. He spoke at the summit's opening with a call to also make the technology more accessible across the globe.
Safety strengthens public trust in AI. No one can deny that safety features are a critical element that determines the competitive edge and sustainability of AI models in the global market. AI safety cannot be truly achieved until those who are the most vulnerable have access to necessary means to respond to threats and challenges posed by this new technology.
Authorities have determined the cause of the fire that razed over a dozen vehicles at the parking lot of the Naia Terminal 3 last month. Our correspondent Robert Mano now on the line with the details. Robert?
Denise, the management of the Manila International Airport Authority has received the report from the Bureau of Fire Protection regarding the cause of the fire in the parking extension of Naia Terminal 3, where 20 vehicles were burned last April 22, 2024. According to MIAA General Manager Eric Jose Ines, the BFP report indicates that the fire was caused by a cigarette butt. Ines also mentioned that they are now ensuring the area is clean by removing dry leaves, adding gravel, installing lights, and increasing the number of CCTV cameras. Regular checks of the parking area are also being conducted. The PSI, which operates the Naia Terminal 3 extension parking, has already spoken with the owners of the burned vehicles. Denise.
Thanks for that, Robert.
The Philippine peso closes once more at 58 to the dollar. The currency stayed in this level the entire day and hit as high as 58 and 20 centavos to the greenback. It first closed at an 18-month low Tuesday. One analyst believes the peso's weakening is a result of contrasting comments from monetary authorities here at home and in the U.S.
The U.S. Federal Reserve said that, you know, they expect rates to be higher for longer, while the BSP said that they could be cutting rates as soon as August. So that sort of dichotomy has caused quite a bit of weakness for the peso. The BSP has now said that they're ready to intervene. I expect them to walk back their comments about a potential rate cut in August. So, you know, this should calm down the market. So I don't expect us to weaken significantly from here.
The European Union Council agrees to use proceeds from frozen assets of the Russian Central Bank to support Ukraine's military. Under the agreement, 90% of the profits or interests from the frozen assets will be allocated to an EU-run fund to provide military aid for Ukraine. The remaining 10% will be used for bolstering Ukraine's defense industry capacities and reconstruction needs. Around 260 billion euros in Russian central bank assets have been immobilized since the war erupted. Russia has denounced the asset seizure, calling it theft.